peaceful for people. I'm with these wonderful, amazing humans. That's right. Listen, I really wanted you here so that we could talk about what's going on backstage with these people, what's going on in their real lives. You know, I don't want to just read their bios. I want to know the dish and the dirt on them.
I know. So they invited Mama here so that I could tell some secrets about the way that they are in the theater. If you were at the first show, you might have heard some of these, so try to act surprised. But we're gonna have some fun. Before we do anything, we want to say thank you to Matthew Raffy for making that extraordinary.
You all are having really an amazing show family. What you guys are doing there is so amazing. Really. It's so cool.
And you're going to see all of it here tonight.
That's
and it
right.
just so happens that our first performer,
yes, dear,
is Matthew.
What?
You know what? Sometimes I'm
going to
have you introduce two people to save a little bit of time.
Yes, so that's what we're going to do as well. So, and the performer that's coming up after that is Kate Sabrina. Making their Broadway debut with Juliet. And we snatched Kate from cable. So I'm going to tell you some secrets. That's my job. My job here tonight is to tell some secrets. A secret from Matthew, other than being a fantastic kind of social media influencer. But also, Matthew passes by my dressing room every performance and greets me. But does so like a cat.
That makes sense.
Yeah, right? Literally meows outside of my dressing room. So that's kind of cute. And it's our little ritual. And also a little tidbit about Kate. Kate is more horizontal than a Caribbean bosom. If you're looking for Kate, Kate will be sleeping somewhere in the theater.
She gets tired.
I mean, the amount of energy, and you will see why, because when Kate gives it to you, she gives it to you, and she will tonight. So first up on the stage, Matthew.
I didn't really know what to sing, to be honest. I was very nervous. And then I was like, maybe something that reflects who I am, this world, and also my dating life, I don't know. And I thought when he sees me, it just fits kind of perfectly with where I'm at. So yeah, great. The guessing game. I don't like guessing games, or when I feel things before I know the feeling. How am I supposed to operate if I'm just tossed around by fate? Like an unexpected aid with a stranger who might talk too fast or ask me questions about myself before I decide that he could ask me questions about myself. He might sit too close. By his person, or eat Oreos, but eat the cookie before the cream. Who scares me the most? Scares me the most. Is what if he sees me? What if he doesn't like it? What if he runs the other way? And I can't hide from it. What happens then? you, so that when he sees me, I want him to. I'm not defensive, I'm not being cautious. I kick you reckless dating due to my miscalculating. Why a certain suitor stands in line, I've seen in movies, what's made for television. You cannot be too careful when it comes to sharing your life. Who will be